in the second one, yeah. Here. I'm just going to say hello, hello, and then I'll ignore you and talk to everyone here. You're admiring the background here.
Yes.
Mm. Yeah. It's exciting, isn't it?
Who's this at?
This is Evie's. Yeah.
Never a dull moment.
I know I always say that.
No.
But on Evie's easel, there's never a dull moment.
There's always some sort of kind of
effulgent thing happening.
Go back and titivate my background at home, I think.
But, it feels as though what you've done with the grey, Annie, I think it's really lovely.
Yes, it's
and
a nice colour.
There's a lovely subtlety in the way that you... No, the thing that you do has that real strength as well, though. There's a subtle kind of underpainting there, but then you pull out things with this drama. You achieve drama in the darks and lights. Like, it's significantly dark in places. And look at that beautifully observed rose. Mm-hmm. You've got the light falling on it, but the chalk pastel.
Those were your wonderful bits of chalk pastel.
So they're cool.
They're lovely. I'm going to go for them.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I appear the big box. I think they're wonderful. They're soft.
I mean,
both of them actually, the oil too, are really good.
The oil are good.
That'll be my next investment.
And I just want to say thanks ever so much to my Sarah Watkins who gave them to me. She'll be watching this maybe. But she just sent me the box of extra soft chalk pastels, which I'd never before had. And they're so bright. Mm-hmm. Like you use them there for the yellow as well. And I think the yellow, particularly with the grey behind, it would have been different if it was this.
Yeah,
on
you
the
were so
side
right to tell me to change that background color. It's so much better.
I'm just laughing at the fact that
it's
highlighting
something with different patterns on it. I love that too, so I should be a bit more adventurous next time.
Mm.
Well, we all get a bit of help from our tutor.
We do.
I can
tell
you.
It wasn't
always going to be like that.
She's wonderful.
Gently
took advice. Persuading.
Yes. Took
advice. Right. And
what would
you play? We're just lamenting the masking tape being really bad. But anyway.
Mine was hopeless. It kept
some of them.
Stick
too well, or they don't stick at all.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Funny, isn't it?
So I thought what I would do, I want to see every side. There, I just want to make sure I see Sylvia as well. And Sylvia is underneath here as well. So maybe I do what we did yesterday and bring
them under the light.
And then you can see.
Take that off and put it around everybody's. You actually see it really well.
We'll start off with your because the thing is around yours. And you can put it on that then as well. So Evie, a really good day again. Yesterday's paintings had this kind of expressive aliveness to them. It felt like there was a little bit of a kind of a softening in today and a relaxed attitude.
Yes,
standing in the sunshine.
I was so taken with Sylvia's watercolours yesterday. I thought I'm going to take that approach today. So.
Yeah. And Sylvia, yours is wrapped up. Yeah. We saw it in that. It was the
<We're on speaker>.
It was inspired.
I think that's good.
I
think that's gorgeous.
It's really not, I don't think it's an easy thing to bring the really, that such contrast in and still retain the delicacy. And you have managed really
well. You're giving a lot of help there, though, and I think. You know, boldly go. I went very boldly, but I did feel that what you were telling me was right. I'd already got quite a lot of dark down, but going in between the delicate stems of the. I think that works.
Yes,
it works.
You did that beautifully.
Yeah.
You bought the blue green colour.
Yeah.
So there was a lovely kind of a grass green happening, and then as you get closer, there's the ultramarine blue mixed in with it. That really allows the. The flowery flowers to just come alive. And then the fact that there's no edge here, you know, you use the paper towel, I think, to stipple
down
it.
Stipple down.
And it feels like there's almost like an aura of light coming from this side then.
Mm-hmm.
And it's always, like I was talking about the contrast again, but just to say again that I think that the beauty of this is the contrast of the really, really dark, opaque paint here.
Yeah.
And the transparent light colour that's over here.
Yeah.
And then everything else, the kind of quirky composition, like choosing to do a landscape format was already new.
Well, I had it in my mind because the minute I saw that pink velvet cloth, I thought there's an L shape there, you know, there's. And I saw it as landscape.
Mm-hmm.
And
it's lovely. Yeah.
There's always the chance you don't like it, you can cut it up.
Yes.
Make it a square
that's
shape.
True.
Yes.
Yeah. And let's just experiment with that. But like, I really don't think this is a clean one. Let me see. Oh, for God's sake. I'm just going to get a clean bit of paper here. Because I want to see how people think about, you know, the difference. I mean, it's lovely, it stands alone anyway, but I think there's something exciting and different.
Well, it looks like a room, it looks like there's a mirror in there, and it's actually whatever you want to see. So
that's right.
That's
if you let the viewer see
what
they want.
It's
what
they want to see.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And it's breathing space.
Yeah,
like for the second one.
Mm.
Yeah. I love the way you paint, Evie. I love the kind of painterly feel of the
look. Thank you.
It's just
thanks
lovely.
To you and coming to your workshops, it helps.
So, yeah. Evie's getting, she's on commission. Okay.
She doesn't pay me for this, honestly.
And then I want to put this around the bottom one as well, because
just to give an idea of what's
gorgeous too.
It does help putting a frame around
it does.
Now that could add, you know, still not sure whether I'd cut off some of that at the bottom.
Oh yeah. You're maybe considering
could maybe do that.
Yes,
yes.
I don't know if you need to, it would be worth looking at it in a couple of days' time.
That's right, yes.
I think that there's something very joyful about this little jug of flowers and the way that it's sitting with the grey pillar behind it. You really captured the lovely kind of cottagey feel of it or something. It's like, when I say cottagey, I suppose it's like
cozy,
a bundle of white flowers.
There's
kind of
a cozy feel about it, yes.
In a kind of a John Eardley way, it's got a raw, wild flower kind of thing going on.
We should use the lucky evening that John Eardley. I love it.
It has that feel though. There's a kind of a spontaneous quality to the brush marks. And then the linear stuff with the chalks and the oil pastels. And I love the way that you do something general first and then come back in with the chalk to enhance
it. Yes, to try not to do too much detail at first. And that's the same with portraiture, as you know. You don't go into the eyes before you've got them.
To
your workshops often enough.
Just to kind of select what's important in order
to
let the Matisse thing, exactitude is not truth to find. The essence of the thing without explaining the life out of it, and this has loads of life in it. There's a lovely liveliness here, and I love the way that you explained that scarf. My aunt sent me that scarf over from Ireland this summer,
nice.
And I just love it.
It's
got a kind of
was that yesterday's?
This is today's.
Yeah,
well,
I work.
That's what Evie does. Evie, in the summertime, over 2 days, did you not have 10 flower paintings?
One of the workshops, yes. They were all of great value, I mean, isn't that? I do work quickly.
Quickly, in that instance especially, I felt like every single one of them.
I work very spontaneously, and if something doesn't work quite early on, I can abandon it.
Mm-hmm.
Less now as I get older, because I'm more persistent, I can change things. If working with acrylic and the other media we've used today, you can cover up, bring out, knock back.
And adjust edges.
With watercolour is more difficult, as you know.
That's true, there's more capacity to come back in with the mixed media. But thanks, Evie. It's really exciting always to see you.
Thank you.
Lovely. Want to maybe put a little bit of masking tape on the other side of this. And we'll bring...
Well, we want me to bring...
I think I can just move this...
Just move it forward.
...to the other... Probably stop it, so that we can see it in the light.
And then even for free, you guys.
It makes such a difference being out of the light.
Yeah.
And with the frame.
See, this is a fine painting.
It is.
Yes.
And the scarf, we've done that. The scarf is lovely too.
Yeah, again, you can recognise that scarf.
Yep.
Just with the
kind of enough detail.
It's again,
A lot of it was accidental, but
well, you know, you had a struggle and you kind of pushed through.
Well,
I could feel the kind of inspiration arising again after lunch or something. You came back and you have this really tenacious way of sticking with something and pulling out the life again.
Mm.
I think that's a really admirable quality of you.
I nearly gave up. Can't do that.
I'm glad I didn't. I'm glad you didn't. I think it worked out beautifully. Mm. And actually, that freshness in the vase is lovely to hold it all together. And from there, there's all these colours to me seem to complement this blue as well.
Hands is a bit wonky, but never mind.
It probably is wonky.
You were presented with a handle that was facing you, and I think you've done it.
That's right.
We know it's one of those jokes. We know it's one of those jokes.
It was lovely to get back into using all these different media. Mm.
Oh, really? Good.
Mm. Very therapeutic day.
Variety of media. I think there's something in that, isn't there, that kind of engages a playful, childlike, experimenting quality when you can reach for different implements and tools and colours to respond to what you're seeing.
And the wonderful thing about the pastels is it brings the life, which acrylics, if you just use them only.
They're very darling, aren't they?
Yeah.
And if you add white,
it just kills it completely.
Yeah.
It's extraordinary, but you know, that pastel, especially that yellow one on the flower, was just
that sold it to me. And actually your blues too, I think a little bit paint, but it really works with the purple flowers.
Yeah.
And there was a lovely light falling on the tops of those lilies that you have captured.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
If I were fiddling with a bit more, I might make the top right corner just a bit darker as it went away.
Mm.
Okay.
I might do that.
Yes.
Yeah, actually, or even I can just put this back up. We knew that was going to happen, so we will make the blessed masking tape. I was just wondering what would happen if we were to bring it down.
It might be better. It's a funny sort of shape. It's a sort of long, thin picture.
But I would say your table is so important in that.
Yes.
You could afford if you didn't want to darken it.
I think
you darken it. But even if you dropped it, I think it wouldn't be out of place. But you must keep your table
in the bottom.
So just the Hooker's green and the crimson red.
Yes.
Any dark green and any dark red will make it green.
I think what I so love about art is that every attempt is a journey into the unknown, and you get effects you don't expect.
Every attempt is a journey into the unknown.
Yeah.
Yes. I love that.
You are, that's one for your next newsletter.
Every attempt is a journey into the unknown.
Write it down and don't remember.
It is an adventure though, isn't it?
Yes,
it
is.
And there's a kind of an open allowing.
It's the joy of doing it.
That kind of naturally arises. You kind of open to the potential and kind of feel your way. And it's very good medicine.
It is.
I feel like it's the best medicine.
I've enjoyed it.
Really gorgeous.
It is.
I just love the jewel-like quality of how you work. It's like a finely tuned. It's a beautiful things here, and then still this spontaneous runs and drips elsewhere, and kind of cross-hatched energetic moves that work really nicely against the considered mark making in here.
It's a good teacher.
Yeah.
Well, I left you alone a lot. Well, occasionally I come in with bright blue option.
Do you know, stand that is worth a great deal too, don't you all agree? Because we've all been tutors who hang over you all the time. And I've been to workshops where I just feel, give me advice, give me a break.
I'm sure that I have tipped over into that area too.
Don't accuse you of that at all.
Exciting. It's lovely to see the things unfolding for me. I feel really inspired.
Well, thank you for that on you.
It's a pleasure. I'm really glad you were able to come and
so am I.
Okay.
And I was feeling so negative about it. You get a bit negative when you're at home all the time.
Oh.
But come out is more
I don't stay much at home for that reason.
Actually, physically moving and getting a change of scene is great.
It does.
It's great, isn't it?
It's
lovely. It's it's well, a nice
again,
space here.
Does everybody live on their own here?
No.
No,
no,
you're not on your own, but I'm on my own.
Yeah,
and I know when I've talked to myself too much.
Yeah.
You know, it's
yes.
time to go out and do
go
something.
Out. Yeah.
Yeah. I couldn't go out to be able to talk to myself. No one listens to me at all. No, this is needing to expand. Is this, oh, it's the same paper, but it's just...
It needs,
really
yes, because
the
images. Yeah.
Just widen a little bit, Chris, Caroline.
It gives you a full picture.
Yeah. Maybe a little too wide now.
Oh, well.
Just a little bit. I can see my friend was out in the garden there. It's way past 4. No.
It's 4 o'clock just
he's
about.
Oh, it's just a bit early.
Yeah. Almost 4.
No, darling. Yeah, lovely.
Okay,
isn't it lovely? And we decided today not to bother with backgrounds. So yesterday and the day before,
yeah,
there was this. So yesterday we had the background that came from the cerulean blue down to the ultramarine,
yeah.
And against the orange and the reds, it was lovely.
Mm-hmm.
And then just to have the kind of line where the masking tape made it stop kind of vertically. And then yesterday, the Wedgwood blue came in to explain the lovely spaces between the composition, and we had the 3 snowberry bundles.
Mm-hmm.
But then today, it felt like there was enough going on.
Uh-huh.
And it filled the space really nicely and left these lovely white shapes of the background. And maybe I'm covering too much on here.
No, no.
We were talking about when the masking tape comes off there,
yeah.
You could just paint the tops of those buds again.
Yes.
I really love that tablecloth as well. You know, you're going to...
It's obliquely nice too.
Yeah, I don't
know. Little bits of... paper stuck on.
Oh, the collage.
Collage,
yes.
That's
yes.
the word I was wanting.
Yeah,
yeah, so there's some here. Is that it for collage?
Yeah, it is
there.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, because you enjoyed the collage with the...
Yes.
Oh, for goodness sake.
Oh,
sorry about this guy.
Yeah.
I'll get there eventually.
I did. Yeah, that's it.
Mm-hmm.
So there's that sweet collage
yes.
there.
Yeah.
That works.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, so... Yeah, I think... Once you explained the handle is tricky.
Yes.
You managed to kind of subdue what was the finding marks that were there, and getting that clarity then allowed you to just take off with the flowers.
Yes.
And there's a lovely filling out in there's beautiful mark making that are the variety of these, you know the name of those, what are they?
Mignostasis, cycle.
Yes, asters.
Asters.
Mignostasis, that's fine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Anyway, they're lovely. And you've got the blue pastel, the soft pastel, to kind of heighten the colour of them. And again, that somehow works really nicely with this. I would never have thought to put those two colours together.
Mm.
And there's something beautiful in the runs of that yellow and the little flashes of green.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually very nice. And to see it alongside this turquoise colour, I think it works beautifully. The horizontal moves there somehow show off
that
watery... thing happening here. And then I felt once you started drawing those lilies and got all the leaves, all these the green arcs in, there's something lovely in how they transport our eye around the painting. Like you were doing these first, and then when you put all the rest of them in and to stand back and see it, I kind of felt again like this is going to work, because no matter what, you've got this lovely route through the painting of the greens.
Right.
But the fact that you've heightened the warm and bright colours of the flowers makes it a satisfying journey through the painting.
Mm-hmm.
There's lots of lovely things to see there.
Yeah.
And those lilies work really well, don't they?
They're lovely to flowers.
Mm-hmm.
They're
the
nice structure.
The colours, the
stuckness. It's not easy, is it, to get the...
Really nice.
It's not easy to get the pinky green balance without it getting muddy.
Mm-hmm.
I think you did a lovely job of that.
Oh, thank
well,
you.
Well done, Caroline.
Mm-hmm.
Great job. No, I know that Sylvia, you've got a few little ones, so maybe the mount isn't needable. We'll see.
Mm. Well,
yeah, you've got that lovely.
In fact, there's some light above there. That's not the mix of bright enough. You can bring it forward a bit.
Yeah. So you started out with these it's your sketchbook, it's gorgeous. You started out painting the full, whatever it should, we're all excited, often.
Yeah.
You were painting the jug with the full still life in it and using watercolour, which is it's a big ask to do the whole thing in one go.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like you made a really lovely job of that jug.
Mm-hmm.
And the contrast between that and this tabletop where you've sprinkled salt on the alizarin.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you did?
Mm-hmm.
Is it alizarin?
Yes,
something
mm-hmm.
that you
mm-hmm.
use there. And the leaves have got some shaved on pencil on them again, do they?
Yes.
So like yesterday's, do you remember the sickening leaves yesterday?
Yeah,
beautiful.
Right.
You used
yeah.
the
mm-hmm. watercolour pencil.
Sandpaper to
yes,
shave water.
Shaved watercolour.
The sandpaper.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
yeah. You know, you were talking about the lily not really working.
I couldn't get the right green and it just became messy.
I don't know. Well, you know, with the mixed media, it's kind of all about the mess, like, but I suppose it's different when you're wanting the purity of watercolour, but I feel like that really did work, that lily. And the leaves have got a lovely dancing quality to them. What I've been really inspired by, Sylvia, is your approach to texture and the way that you create inspiring surfaces kind of without having a plan in advance so much, but a little bit of a plan, but then being willing to kind of take it in different directions. And this is the rose. Those leaves are lovely.
Mm.
I hadn't actually studied this before. But again, you've got that thing of the bleeding edges. And these are so very rose-like.
Mm.
It couldn't be anything else. Like. And then the salmon colour, how did you end up doing that? In the
just
end?
With
the
orange watercolour. I think it, well, I did observe the leaves, but doing the roses is difficult.
Not
really something I've done a lot of.
No.
Of roses that
yeah.
treacherously difficult.
But
I've
never managed to pull off a rose properly. Really.
I think we all tend to put too much detail into them.
Yeah,
I think. Observe
yeah.
a bit more. It does make a difference
mm-hmm.
to observe what I'm looking at and you know try and paint what I'm seeing.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely learned that over the last couple of days.
Mm-hmm. And you did this beautiful autumnal leaf.
Yeah,
it's gorgeous. And this is the same effect of, I don't know what it is that you've done.
Salt
and
a bit of the watercolour pencil.
Mm-hmm.
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 Interesting.
So if you put
mm-hmm.
salt on it, what do you do?
Yeah.
You let it dry.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Put salt on and let it, yes, right, wait
it
to dry.
Okay.
And then it'll flake off when it's dry.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
interesting.
Isn't that gorgeous?
It's
a little bit of salt on it.
It's based on the lake at Killarney.
Lakes of Killarney?
Yeah. Just overlooking one of the lakes.
Mm-hmm.
Gorgeous.
Yeah.
Colors.
And there's just really, I think it's really exciting to see
yeah.
the kind of natural patterns that happen and that you let them alone and then you do something more
mm-hmm.
vigorous somewhere else. This is the limestone
mm-hmm.
recognizance.
Burn.
And then this is using cling film over the watercolour.
Yeah.
That
could
be something crazy doing.
Yeah.
It's all on YouTube.
Great stuff.
Thank you. Lovely.
Pleasure.
It's so different from the rest of us, but it's lovely.
Yeah.
So delicate.
It is, isn't it?
Yes.
You really did
really
stick
nice.
With it.
Yes.
It was lovely
mm-hmm.
to see all the all the watercolour surrounding you in the afternoon and just to see you kind of experimenting with different things. There was quite a few different kind of things
mm-hmm.
played with. And I think that's the reason we come to a workshop is to kind of have permission to play things out, is this play about.
Yes.
Yeah, it's really, really lovely. Thanks for making
super.